I'm Jason Raichert with Ed Raichert Sewing Machine in Phoenix, Arizona. The class we're covering today is all about your tension assembly. Today we're going to take apart the tension assembly, show you how to change the check spring, how to clean the tension assembly, and also how to change the upper tension on it. This tension assembly is commonly found in many single needle lock stitch sewing machines. Machines made by Juki, Singer, Conso, and Brother often use these, as well as the Gammel disc tensioner that we have on our website at Raichert.com. Removing the tension assembly is easy. All of these tension assemblies are held in with a collar and a set screw that comes in from the side. If you loosen the set screw, you do not need to remove it all the way. It should allow you to slide out and remove the tension assembly, which I have right here. Not all tension assemblies are held in place with an external set screw. Check the manual that came with your machine for proper removal instructions. The first step to cleaning the tension discs and changing the check spring is to remove all of the parts of the tension assembly. The tension assembly is under pressure, so it's a good idea to hold this spring compressed while you unscrew the nut and the ferrule from the device. Remove the cone spring, remove the tension disc presser, and both tension discs. Next, we need to remove the tension stud. This will be done using the small screw on the bottom. Using a narrow blade screwdriver, compress the tension stud with your fingers and use the screwdriver to turn the set screw 1/2 turn. You do not need to remove the screw entirely. The tension stud should slide out of the tension assembly. Remove the broken or damaged check spring from the tension barrel. Use canned air to remove any loose debris from the tension barrel. Any non-chlorinated degreaser will work to clean the inside. Using the Q-tip with the degreasing solvent, clean the inside of the barrel to remove any debris that may still be stuck in there. Apply citrus degreaser to lint-free towel. These blue shop towels are great and can be used all over in maintenance of sewing machines. Clean each piece thoroughly, whether it touches the thread or does not touch the thread. When it comes to the cone spring, oftentimes the Q-tip is a better option to get all the way through it. Always good to get the outside of the tension assembly. I also like to use the Q-tip on the spring. Now that we have cleaned all the parts, we need to reassemble the tension assembly. Even with this lightly used tension assembly, you can see the amount of dirt and debris buildup. This would have ended up onto the thread and into your project. As you can see, sewing machine maintenance will not only prolong the life of your machine, but also make your projects better in the end. Install the new check spring by sliding it inside the cylinder through the groove on the outside of the barrel, lining the groove of the tension post up with the tail of the check spring is crucial in the disc tension assembly. When the tension post is properly lined up with the tail of the check spring, you will feel the check spring tension increase when you turn the stud to the right. In order to set the initial check spring tension, we will turn the tension stud 180 degrees to the right. While still holding the tension assembly tight between your thumb and forefinger, tighten the set screw near the bottom of the assembly. At this point, the tension stud should be firmly in place so you cannot move it from left to right, and the check spring should have tension on it so that when you move it, it bounces back quickly. With the tension stud firmly in place, we will install the two tension discs with the concave sides facing each other. Next is the tension disc presser. This is installed with the concave side facing towards the bottom of the assembly and the bar in the middle through the split pin on the tension post. Next is the cone or beehive spring. Be sure to install this with the tail of the spring in place between the tension post bar. The contact washer needs to be installed with the teeth facing away from the spring. Last, we have the nut. The plain side will face the operator. The side with teeth must interact with the contact washer teeth and then tighten. The check spring, when perfectly installed, should snap back, and you can increase your upper tension by tightening the nut. The tension assembly is one of the key parts of your machine. The check spring regulates your upper tension, and when installed properly, you can easily adjust the upper tension with the tension nut.